roll up to you. You gave us a great explanation about sort of why and where you all are doing this, these various assessments. How about an example of where you all have been forging this technology and then perhaps imparting some wisdom to the members and then perhaps a reaction back from them? Or just tell us how this works. Give us an example of where you all have been, examining this technology and enlightening the members.
Sure. Thanks, Luke. I really do think I really like what the general laid out in terms of there's a lot of this really is about better decisions, faster decisions, more data informed decisions. Mm-hmm. And I think I am a science guy. I love the sci-fi movies, but unfortunately, the vacuum that's been filled in on AI is always this apocalyptic thing. Either we're all going to lose our jobs or we're all going to get destroyed by killbots. Both of those are we're very far from anything even close to that. This really is about augmentation. So I think of AI as an augmentation of intelligence and really helping with these things. So for us at GAO, we are really about converting data into knowledge. And ultimately, we want to inform our members and support wisdom so that better laws get passed or better oversight occurs. And so data is the basis of that. And that's how we sort of think about our value chain and what we're doing on that. So one of the things you mentioned, foraging, Luke, of the technology, we have foraged. We're using cloud-native tooling sets and things like that to leverage the power of cloud as we have transformed ourselves from an on-prem IT, or we're still in that process. But setting up our innovation lab, we're able to have a greenfield startup. So I think that in that domain, we've been able to do some incredible things with relatively little, very powerful. One example is that we've both foraged the technology from cloud native IT, but also forged in terms of taking those and making a new tool set. So we've been, basically we've created our own, for GAO, our own writing style, our own version of Grammarly or a tool like that to help out. And the reason is because we have to be stewards of federal data of all types across the government. We can't send our data out, as is with that system, out to some unknown cloud that we have no control of. We have no idea what's being used. So we're able to, with just relatively few of our data scientists, put together quickly a prototype that does, that understands and speaks and understands writing in GAO's way, and then helps even do sentiment analysis, because we are a nonpartisan agency. That's very important. Our job isn't to take any sides in the political sphere, but our job is to inform that. So we have sentiment analysis going on through natural language processing. We have the grammatical checking, and we also need to write to a certain level, especially when I'm the managing director of a team with a lot of really smart science and engineer types, right? Almost doing a translational service into our lawmakers who are very sharp and know their issues, but oftentimes don't know science or engineering. How do we write in such a way that makes it accessible? So that's very important to us. That's a seemingly small example, but something that with NLP, AI-enabled, data-fueled type things, we're really changing for the better how we're serving our clients.